Lafferty and Bethany Joy Lenz. This is a request from Jada Smith, just kind of going over all the personal hidden relationship, the things about the couple, or, you know, the two that were, they were acting. I don't think they dated or anything, but we're going to find out kind of the internal of the relationship, as well as just, you know, the superficial one that we're aware of. So just kind of getting the current state of things and what it was back in the day. They were in a show together, I believe. I'm going to go over their astrology really quick. Okay. She was born April 2nd, 1981. She's an American actress, director, producer, and musician, best known for her portrayal as Haley James on the CW television drama One Tree Hill. She is a Aries, I think. Sun sign is an Aries. Moon is a Pisces. Her Venus is an Aries. That's some water. Fire. Okay. James Lafferty was born July 25th, 1985 in California, United States. He's an American actor, director, and producer. He is best known for his portrayal of Nathan Scott in the CW series One Tree Hill. He is a Leo sun sign, so the moon sign is a Scorpio, and his Venus is a Gemini. Gemini, I see two of you. Okay, let's get into their reading. So I'm going to find out the current energy surrounding the situation. Just kind of overall what masking the situation. Okay. Could have given them some sort of change enough to transform them. Kind of at peace. Maybe it's hard to tell. Not sure if it is or not, but peace has something to do with the overall masking of the energy of the situation between the two of them. Transformation definitely has something to do with this. My fertility, lacking ability to have a baby, or just lacking need for fertility issues, or just in general, like there is no talking about fertility. Let's get into the tarot card reading that will confirm the current energy around the situation. All right, let's find out about the celebrities. So we're just going to go overall a couple cards here, kind of discussing who they are, okay? I'm getting into... Okay. Just getting into anything that we pick up on here. So this will confirm the oracle, though. Kind of melt those together to get our storyline, so... She's lacking communication with him. She's not really chatting with him, especially because it has been unpredictable probably in the past mostly. And she's, when she's thinking about the situation, it's just like she thinks a lot of untrue things about it. Her thoughts on the inside are kind of diluting what it actually was. So whatever it was is not the same as how she thinks about it or how she feels about it, if that makes sense. She definitely, at one time, they probably had some sort of strong relationship, but it is all about lack of anything here. So she's definitely not vibing on anything. Again, that transformation card is just confirming the oracle reading. So over on his end of things, he's dealing with some heartbreak. I don't know what it has to do with. I don't know if it has anything to do with this reading with Bethany in general, but he was definitely going through a really difficult moment, and he's not communicating about it. He's not talking about it. He's in a transformation. He's in a shift. He's in a push. He's definitely, something changed in his life. Definitely something changed. Probably has something to do with almost hostility, or like he feels like it's probably an unfair thing. All right, let's get into a challenge for the past for them. What was the biggest challenge between the two of these people? Wow, lots of reverse here. Okay, so there was no stability or romance really at all in this relationship, passion. that was one of the biggest challenges about the relationship, the love connection, or, you know, getting into a place where there's, it's completely a complete relationship, emotional. None of these things were going on. All they were really doing was learning how to be inventive in whatever it was that they were doing together. And they were working there. There's a lot of ambition talk here. There's a lot of talk about what it is they do that makes them tick. So the passion that runs their life. Okay. But the connect here was just more or less lack of any expression. There was lack of emotion, lack of anything. Let's get into the challenge that is present with the two of these. Goodness. It's just like there's not a whole lot going on here. Presently there is somewhat of a conflict. Even going over the memories or kind of like stoking things up for them, it just doesn't bring a whole lot of achievement, or it doesn't bring up, you know, the good old days for them. There's a lot of insecurity written around their relationship for some reason. I don't know why. Oh, you're welcome. Absolutely welcome. It was interesting. The tangible or the dependability in this relationship went out the fucking door, especially presently, because there is a conflict. There's something underneath the surface. But again, the memories don't really make them want to push and shove to get into, you know, normalcy. They're not going to reunite or anything like that. It's just not like that. It's just not like that with them. Let's get likely intention from the both of them. What kind of action do they have coming in? All right, so she's not going to communicate. There's trauma here. Trauma is being brought up. Any kind of trauma, it's just not being spoken about. She doesn't talk about it. It was very hostile, uncomfortable probably, and very confusing for her. But there's definitely the thoughts of the situation are not rational. It's with these cards, it's just indicating that any kind of clarity in the mind about the trauma or the, you know, I don't know what this is. Hello? Hello? Oh, don't worry about it. You're not interrupting at all. The phone did. I'm like, what? Anyway, so there is some sort of a revenge kind of energy here, but it's almost like the conflict or the grief of the situation is so great. It's like the revenge is almost too much for her to bear. I don't know what happened. There is no healing on his end. He's not going to bring any healing to her, and he doesn't want to guide her through the situation. He's not bringing himself into a conversation or into any sort of moment in which he thinks he's going to give her power as far as getting into a more balanced place because of something, you know, she thinks has happened. This is so weird. Because there's deluded thoughts that she does have. And I did mention that. So that is very weird. Likely outcome here. Likely outcome for the upcoming month. Where are we at on this situation? I'm like, oh my God, what's going to happen? Okay. Again, with this King of Swords upright, Hangman upright, we've got the Star in reverse. It's just lacking all sorts of balance here. The inspiration, the balance, the healing, all of the good stuff is not in this. And it's not going to open up like a portal of love or anything like that. This is just going to go nowhere. The surrendering is probably the most important part, I would think, in this reading. I feel as if the knowledge is going to be gained here. And I feel like she's going to be, you know, kind of buckled down, and it's going to change or shift the way that she is seeing this situation. So she's going to, you know, she's going to, all of a sudden there's going to be some information brought about within the next month or so here, and it is going to change things around. But I mean, inspiring? No, she's not inspired at all. I don't know what you did, James Lafferty, but she is pissed the F off at you and hates probably. She wants to revenge your existence. Okay, I'm getting the hell up here. Thank you so much for checking in with this reading. I hope that you enjoyed it. Again, it was kind of a weird, creepy reading. I don't know what the hell's going on there. But please hit subscribe to Hangman Tarot if you would, please, and thank you. And if you would go ahead and click that bell so you don't miss any of your notifications for future tarot card readings here. Share, like, and follow on your social media. Check out the video that pops up on the upload. You're going to go ahead and check it out. And if you have any requests for celebrities, get a hold of me in the social media in the details or leave a comment. Otherwise, enjoy the rest of your evening, guys. Bye.